Welcome to Reflective Mind. This is your host Monica. As we were discussing the keys to power, first key was love, second key was gratitude. Today we would be discussing third key, that is clay, the key of clay. What does this key does? Let's see. There is one certain way you can make yourself feel better about any subject in your life, and that is to create games with your imagination and play. Isn't that fun? That sounds fun. Play is fun, and so when you play, you feel really good. At some point, we stop playing and having fun like we did as a children, with the result that as we become adults, we become more serious about life. But seriousness brings the serious circumstances into your life. When you play and have fun, you feel really good, and voila, really good circumstances come into your life. Life is supposed to be fun. Play with the law of attraction, invent games with your imagination, because law of attraction doesn't know or care if you are imagining or playing or if it is real. Whatever you give in imagination and feeling will become real. How to play? Now the question is like how to apply this technique. The law of love could be best understood and learned through the little children. Mahatma Gandhi. How do you play? You do the same thing as you did when you were a child, and you use your imagination to create make-believe games. Let's imagine you are a cyclist and you want to become best cyclist in the world and win the Tour de France. Your training is going well and you have your dreams in your sight, but you are diagnosed with a disease at given a 40% chance to survive. While having treatment, you imagine you are riding in a Tour de France and it is the race of your life. You imagine the medical staff is your training team giving you feedback at every checkpoint. Each day, you imagine you are racing. You are racing back to your health. You win the Tour de France and you continue to win it 7 years in a row, becoming the one cyclist in the history to achieve that. This is what Lance Armstrong did. He used the most circumstances as the props to create the imaginary game and realize his dreams. Let's say you want to have the best built body in the world, and you also want to become a famous actor in America. You live in a tiny village in Europe and come from a family that has struggled financially, but still you imagine your dreams. You use a picture of a hero to sculpt your body, and you imagine winning the European Little for the best built body. You win the Little 7 times, and then it is a time to become famous actor. You travel to America, but no one believes you are actor material, and they give you all the reasons why you will never achieve your dreams. But you have imagined being famous actor, and you can feel the success, you can taste it, and you know it will happen. This is the Arnold Schwarzenegger did when he won the Mr. Olympia 7 times and then became one of the biggest names in Hollywood. Imagine you want to be a great inventor in your childhood. Your mind is challenged to the extreme. You are overwhelmed with the hallucinations and blinding flashes of light. You fail to finish university and leave your job due to the nervous breakdown. To gain relief from the crippling hallucinations, you take control of your mind and creating your own imaginary world. Inspired by the idea of brighter future, you direct your imagination to the new inventions. You build an invention completely in your imagination. You change the construction, make improvements, and even operate the device without ever drawing a sketch. You create a laboratory in your mind, and you use your imagination to check the new inventions for the wear and tear, because before tearing your idea into the physical device, this is what Nikola Tesla did to become one of the greatest inventors. Whether it was the alternating current motor, radio amplifier, wireless communication, fluorescent light, laser beam, remote control, or any of his other 300 plus patented inventions, all of them had been developed exactly this way, through the power of imagination. Logic will get you from A to B. Imagination will take you anywhere. Albert Einstein. Whatever it is you want, use your imagination. Create games and play. Use every prop you can find to help you. If you want to lose weight or have a better body, create games so you feel as though you have the body now. You can surround yourself with the pictures of the great bodies. But the trick is this. You must imagine those bodies are yours. You must imagine and feel that you are looking at body, not somebody else's body. If you are overweight or underweight and you had the perfect weight right now, how would you feel? You would feel different from how you feel now. Everything about you would change. You would walk differently, talk differently, and you would do things differently. Walk like that, talk like that. Now, act as if you have it now. It doesn't matter what it is that you want. Imagine how you would feel with it and act like that now in your imagination. Whatever you imagine with feelings, you are giving to the law of attraction. You must receive it. Lance Armstrong and Arnold Schwarzenegger, Nikola Tesla, all these people played their imagination and felt their dreams with all their heart. Their imaginations became so real to them, they could feel their dreams and now know they would happen. It doesn't matter how far your dream seems to you. It is closer to you than anything in your life, because all the power to bring your dream to you is inside you. Everything is possible for the person who believes. Jesus. In the future, we will see more and more discoveries about the power of imagination. Already scientists have discovered the special mirror cells that activates the same areas in the brain when you imagine doing something as when you physically perform the action. In other words, simply by your playing and imagining what you want to experience, your brain is immediately responds as if it is real. If you're talking about something in the past or future, you're imagining those things. Now you're feeling those things. Now you are on the frequency now, and that's what the law of attraction is receiving. When you are imagining your dream, the law of attraction is receiving it now. Remember, there is no time for the law of attraction. There is only this moment of now. If you experience a time delay in receiving what you want, it is only because of the time it takes you to get onto the same feeling frequency that your desire is on. And to get onto the same frequency as your desire, you have to feel the love of having your desire now. When you get yourself onto the same feeling frequency and stay there, what you desire appears. All you can possibly need or desire is already yours. Call your desires into being by imagining and feeling your wish fulfilled. Neville Goddard. When you are really excited about anything that has happened and you feel amazing, capture that energy and imagine your dream. Quick flashes of imagining and feeling your dreams are all you need to harness the power of your excited feelings for what you want. This is playing. This is fun. This is joy of creating your life. How much easier it could get for you. Just guys, start playing games with your imagination. Generate new ideas. Think of the things you desire in your life and fulfill your dreams. I wish you all best of luck for your lives and loads of love and abundance to you all. Do like and subscribe my channel. See you in the next session. Bye-bye. Have a great day.